Welcome to this segment of Citizens Forum. Yes, the recording is different than the usual Citizens Forum segments. This recording is being done from home studio April 28, 2020, in the midst of the COVID-19 virus lockdown. Like many other facilities, the Shaw Studio normally used to record local community TV is not available. This segment is about WorkSafe BC, primarily the Jada Patterson Workers' Compensation Review, which has sat on the Minister of Labor's desk since the middle of October 2019. I understand the report contains 100 recommendations which are not being addressed with the public in any meaningful way. There are several other reports that have been done on WorkSafe BC in the past few years, all identifying areas where WorkSafe needs to improve. To date, little to nothing has been done to implement many of these much-needed changes. Far too many injured workers in D.C. are being unjustly denied claims and fair compensation for their injuries sustained while building a better D.C. I am one of those workers. My name is Norm Ryder. I was injured while working on a project to provide irrigation for the farmers in the Okanagan. My benign brain tumor was caused by a massive dose of microwave radiation, possibly as high as 400 times over the excessively high Health Canada safe limits. At the end of 2020 will be the end of the 10th year of my descent into what can be described as a descent into a WorkSafe weird and wacky wonderland. That is far too similar to Lewis Carroll's Wonderland than any process based on natural justice. Unfortunately, my experiences are far too common and shared by many. A number of these experiences were presented to Janet Patterson during her review. Experience such as one person having to explain to WorkSafe that an injury they were fully recovered from over 25 years earlier when they fell off a horse was not related to the current injury and most definitely was not associated with falling off a house. Yes, only one letter difference between horse and house, but WorkSafe created the fact that they had fallen off a house and therefore the injured worker was mistaken in lying about their recovery from the previous injury. Another injured worker was forced to go back to work when they had a bone chip floating around to their foot. Many injured workers will recognize these as similar to their own experiences. In my case, they refused to accept radiation exceeding their own safety limits by 400 times is harmful because doing so would mean they would have to honor my claim. Many jurisdictions around the world, including BC, trace the origins of the workmen's compensation to a 1913 Royal Commission out of Ontario done by an Honorable Sir W.R. Meredith titled Final Report on Law Relating to the Liability of Employers to Make Compensation to Their Employees for Injuries Received in the Course of Employment, which are in force in other countries. Bit of a mouthful. This led to what is known as a historical bargain, or sometimes referred to as a grand compromise, when workers gave up their rights to sue their employer in the event of workplace injury in exchange for a no-fault, science-based insurance program to compensate them in the event of an injury. My grandfathers were working in 1917. Neither of them would have given up my right to sue the employer in exchange for a system such as WorkSafe BC is today. An Osgood Law Hall Journal article, A Historical Perspective on Contemporary Challenges in Workers' Compensation by Terence Izzard. An administration of workers' compensation was initially established at the boards. Relatively little use was made of lawyers. Indeed, one of the goals of the Meredith Report was to avoid the cost and delay of involving the legal profession. It was recognized, however, as the administration of workers' compensation was initially established at the boards, relatively little use was made of lawyers. Indeed, one of the goals of the Meredith Report was to avoid the cost and delay of involving the legal profession. It was recognized, however, that the workers' compensation claims would involve medical issues. Doctors were hired by the boards and they became the dominant profession in claims adjudication. Propensity for staff doctors to become decision makers rather than medical advisors. These programs were based on scientific fact rather than on the convoluted legal arguments to assess an injured worker's claim. Since then, the program has morphed into a convoluted quasi-judicial system operating in the principles not akin to the normal legal system and denying natural justice. More like a schoolyard bully running a kangaroo court. I have prepared a separate video looking at more of the Janice Patterson review, asking Minister Baines to release the report immediately.
On April 3rd, 2019, the BC government announced a review of WorkSafe BC, or workers' compensation if you prefer, would be undertaken by a lawyer, Janet Patterson. The news release stated, a report including possible recommendations will be delivered to the government by September 30th, 2019. It was not delivered until the middle of October 2019, possibly because the report by necessity was larger than anticipated or because of the non-support by the business community at the review, as reported by Richard Zussman, Global News, August 14, 2019. Headline, BC's largest business organizations are backing out of the government latest review of WorkSafe BC because they have lost confidence. The report has languished on the minister's desk from October 2019, and it does not appear will be made available to the public in their foreseeable future, as suggested in an article by Andrew McLeod at the Taiyi magazine, January 31st, 2020. Headline, the BC Federation of Labour has urged the provincial government to release a controversial report on improvements to supports for workers who get hurt or sick on the job. The report was submitted to the Labour Minister, Harry Baines, in October, but there has been no indication when the government will release the report to the public or act on it. The following month, Andrew reported, Baines said some of the changes are coming during the current session of the legislature, which is scheduled to end in May, but they won't be based on the Patterson report. Even before the cessation of the legislative process in BC caused by the COVID virus lockdown, there was concern with the next general election scheduled for October 16th, 2021, assuming the fragile minority government survives that long. Approximately 6 months before a scheduled general election, many politicians ceased dealing with legislation for the people and the people's business, or even doing much for the people as they shift their focus to what many deem to be their most important job, getting re-elected. There's a strong probability the previous political party may return to government. The party that when last in power made many of the changes to WorkSafe BC that are proved unworkable and the genesis of the requirement for some of the many reviews of WorkSafe. One of the party spokesmen for WorkSafe in an email to me demonstrated a serious lack of understanding of the legislation under which WorkSafe operates. Lori Thrones, BC Liberal MLA for Chilliwack, Kent, advised me by email. WorkSafe is a large insurance company. He then goes on to talk about an accident fund and does not address the funds that WorkSafe declares a surplus to their needs. WorkSafe is a Crown corporation with a legislated responsibility to look after injured workers, as Andrew McLeod points out in his articles. WorkSafe surplus funds, as reported in their 2018 annual report, are in excess of $3 billion. In excess of 128% overfunded or sufficient that WorkSafe could operate at its present rate of not looking after injured workers for 3 years without receiving premiums from employers. It is a concern of many BC injured workers that the report will not be released. If it is released, it will be delayed until it is too late for any legislative changes required. It is a real possibility that in any election, the ruling party will lose their mandate and other political parties. BC Liberals and BC Green Party are even less likely to implement changes in the Workers' Compensation Act or in WorkSafe policies and improvements to their policies and regulations that require WorkSafe to fulfill their mandate of assisting injured workers. The delay in releasing the report has the feeling of providing the employers what they wished for when they withdrew from the investigation process by derailing the report implementation. On May 3, 2016, Minister Baines, then a member of the opposition, appeared at the estimates for the Ministry of Jobs, Tourism, Skills Training, requesting WorkSafe confer special considerations for one of his constituents. A favor that the now Mr. Baines is not anxious to allow any other injured workers to receive. His appearance in the committee room is significantly different than my current MLA's actions, who, despite his party having signed the confidence and supply agreement with a statement, improved fairness for workers and ensuring balance in the workplace are shared priorities between the government and the BC Green Party, my current MLA told me that if he helped me with my WorkSafe case, it would be illegal. Isn't it the prime function of an elected MLA to help constituents with challenges dealing with government agencies? Some information about the Patterson report has been leaked out. It has in the order of 100 recommendations in the report. After 6 months, the public and especially the injured workers deserve to know what is in the report. It can be assumed some of the changes are significant and will, if implemented, return WorkSafe to as it was envisioned in the foundation document, a Royal Commission titled the Meredith Report of over 100 years ago. One may possibly assume three recent investigations into WorkSafe may contain hints as to the changes Ms. Patterson has noted. The WorkSafe BC Review and Action Plan, much of this report deals with some of the aftermath of the sawmill fires. Balance, stability, and improvement options for the accident fund. And the third, restoring the balance, worker-centered approach to workers' compensation policy. If anything, most people caught in the WorkSafe process would say the system has become even worse since July 2012 when Tom Sanborn wrote in an article in the Taiyi. If anything, most people caught in the WorkSafe process would say that the system has become even worse since July 2012 when Tom Sanborn wrote his article in the Taiyi. Despite new rules, mentally injured and bullied workers still disadvantaged. Critics' concerns raised that the laws passed to fix BC workers' compensation missed the point. No employer I've spoken to expresses satisfaction with how WorkSafe operates, especially after I tell them how much surplus to their needs WorkSafe has in their coffers. Injured worker satisfaction with WorkSafe is very low as well. Workers that have been surveyed by WorkSafe have expressed concern to me that if they responded to the survey with unfavorable answers, WorkSafe would cut off their benefits. Often the survey is done at a point of the claim where negotiations can be difficult to obtain a fair settlement, and the workers are afraid to express concerns they will be treated unfavorably by WorkSafe if they do not express satisfaction with WorkSafe. And of course, those injured workers arbitrarily and unjustly denied their claims are excluded from the survey. When no charges were laid after the tragic sawmill fires because investigations into the fire by WorkSafe were so compromised by WorkSafe investigators, the Crown prosecutors felt there was no probability of a conviction. One does wonder if WorkSafe has the intent of protecting injured workers. Minister Baines, your government has shown they can move fast to alleviate the plight of the homeless during the COVID-19 crisis. Don't the injured workers of BC deserve similar swift action, especially as many of the homeless and users of the food bank are injured workers that have been ejected from the system by WorkSafe? Minister Baines, release the Patterson report without delay. The longer you hold it, the less confidence injured workers in BC have that they will be treated fairly by WorkSafe BC.